I know from teaching thousands of students, the one question I get asked the most is about cue points. Now, firstly, cue points are markers you can set in the track that essentially allow you to jump to and play the best parts of each track. So for instance, right, let's say you're jamming a track and perhaps you're like the second half, but the first half's really boring, right? Well, with cue points, right, you can go and find the parts that you want to play and you can set cue points, usually in your DJ software, sorry, before you even start playing. And the cue points, they allow you to jump straight to the part of the track that you wish to play. So essentially, you can go in and map the best parts of the song. As without cue points, right, you're either limited to start from the first beat of the song, or every single time you load the track, you're gonna be looking for the part that you wanna play, which can be a little bit of a hassle. Now, personally, right, I think mixing with and without cue points, both have their time and place and their advantages. And it can depend a lot on the genre of music that you're playing and also your goals. So for instance, right, when mixing EDM or even the heavier styles of house, so let's call that drum and bass, trap, hardstyle, trance, even some tech house, right, I feel with those genres, it's about playing the best parts of the track. And sure, I can not use cues and I can take guesses by looking at the waveforms and I can probably make things line up, right, relatively well, right, which I'll do in the video coming. But it can be limiting, as with those genres, right, I feel it's more about playing the best parts of the track, and with cue points, I can 100% bring a new level of excitement to the way that I mix. For instance, right, a few weeks ago, I did this 3-deck tech house set, right, and I'll link it in now, but with this set, I pretty much mix constantly, and a mix like that, you're really gonna need to set cue points, as I was keeping the energy moving and I was playing what I felt was the best parts of each track. Without cues, there's no way I could have mixed like that. However, right, mixing without cues can also be really cool, as it means you can hit the decks without having to do all the preface, let's face it, right? Sometimes, you know, let's say you've got decks, you're just impatient, you just want to start playing. And to be honest, right, you have a much better chance of that working with the deeper kinds of house or even techno, where the tracks are, they feel more drawn out. And then perhaps with those genres, mixing without cues may even be better, as without cues, it becomes less about playing the best bits, but more about the overall journey, which honestly, that's also lots of fun. Now, personally, I feel you should be able to do both. So sure, I feel the majority of DJs playing live most likely are using cue points, as with cue points, like, it gives you a safety net. But then again, right, if you turn up to a mate's party and they have decks there, you should be able to jump on and navigate music you've never played before and still be able to make it sound great with or without cue points. So in this video, right, I'm gonna jam a playlist that I've never played before. Like, honestly, on my life, like, I haven't touched it, right? But sure, to make it a little bit easier for myself, and I suggest that you do the same, I chose a particular genre. I use tracks that are close in BPM, which is good for beginners, right? And also, if you don't know the tracks and you're getting to know them through jamming them, right, I suggest that you also look at the keys and you mix harmonically, as this is mixing harmonically. It's gonna increase your chances of making that sense, like the set sound more professional. Now, if you're not sure what I mean by mixing harmonically, right, I have a video in my free mini course, which I'll link in below, that includes almost 20 Learn to DJ videos, and included in them is a video on where to set cue points for all the different genres, and also how to mix harmonically. So I'll link that in below, but check it out. A lot of people rave about it to me. So anyway. So let's do this right now. By the way, right, I've decided to do this video using New Disco, as I find New Disco sits perfectly in the middle of a lot of genres. So for instance, it has a house vibe, right, which means I can probably draw it out, but it also has vocals, which means then, you know, sometimes I might have to do faster transitions. Now, between you and me, right, I just downloaded these tracks this morning, put them into a playlist, and have not practiced them at all, right? So in that sense, this is gonna be a little bit unpredictable, and in my opinion, that makes this perfect, because mixing without cue points can also be unpredictable. So let's hope I can bring it to life, eh? Like, without any prep. So let's do it. And not, like I said, I'll probably be looking at the keys. So let's give it a go. Okay, cool. Okay, we got, yep. Okay, we're going. So just go to my next song. Oh, well, song on here. So let's go New Disco. Okay, so then, okay, I've got 5A there. So I'm looking at the actual original keys. How about I pick another song at 5A here? okay, to start with, why not? Okay, cool. Make sure the master tempo's on, match the BPMs. Okay. Realistically, a lot of people, I'm teaching beginners, and what happens is they just hear a one, they come in straight away. But realistically, this is still your intro. You've got to allow some of the song to play. So, okay. So I guess also what I'm doing is I'm kind of like feeling the song, but also looking at the rise and falls of the waveform, you know, just to kind of see. So what a lot of people do is, it's coming up to a drop now, like the first beat of the chorus. A lot of people hit play here, right? And that's assuming that your intro and your chorus are the same length, okay? But, I don't know. It's always gonna be safer to come in closer to the end here. So I might stop it. If I came in closer to the end of the chorus, that's gonna be safer for sure. Maybe let's go with that. Let's try that, let's see. Cool. I might do that filter trick I spoke about. I don't know if I'll go just yet. I might wait for it to drop off. Well, okay, if I wanted to be kind of fancy, let's say I didn't want that to kick in, maybe I could loop it. Maybe I could add some echo to it, make it really fun. Okay, cool. See what I mean? It's heaps of fun. And see, I was worried. I didn't know that what that was gonna do. So I heard that, and I thought, okay, let's grab it, create a little build, essentially. It would have been better if that then landed and then just kicked in. But, you know, that's the thing. I don't really know. Oh, I don't know the songs, I'll be honest, I don't. So let's go, that was 5A. Let's go to this next one. Okay, I think that's a one. Okay. Loop that back to the beginning, play it safe. Actually, you know what? Now that I'm playing this, actually, I'd probably let that bit go. That sounds pretty cool. I'll loop that back. Okay, and in this case now, I don't think I could really mess with that. I'm gonna have to wait for the drop. And that's the thing, I guess in time you play enough that you kind of just get to know music. See, this is gonna build up, and if I then, let's say it's building up and then it's about to go to something and I don't let it go to the thing that's building up to, that's very, very risky. Come in on this drop and hopefully they kind of like land. Let's see. Okay, again, it's coming in though with a fair bit. If you're unsure, I might let it go for 16 bars before coming in. So I'll just reset it so you can see what I'm doing. So that would be. Gonna be a lot safer. Do you know what I mean? Yeah, see, I've done this a lot. So this is actually going way better than I anticipated. Start giving me this one. Yeah, I get rid of this. Yeah, I filtered that back anyway, it's gone. Cool. Okay. 7A, what else have I got? Okay. Let's get this one. Another one. Again though, see what I'm doing? I'm looking here in this waveform. It's always gonna be safe to try and mix into the middle there. If I came in here, it may be a bit quick, you know. I could do it for the next one to just show you. Actually, you know what? Let's make it fun. I personally wouldn't come in here, but let's see what happens. Way safer because I'm coming in over the end of the chorus. Different though to my three deck one, right? Three deck one was more like, now I'd be like thinking of the next one, have something on top of that, but still, let's see what else we got. Okay, I'm just picking songs that are harmonically compatible. And if you're not sure what that means, I've got a free video on my free video course about harmonic mixing. I'm using the Camelot system right now. The fact that that's kicking with a vocal, I might retreat on this. See, I haven't swapped the basses on this yet, so this song with the vocal is my main one. I haven't committed to this. So sometimes if you come in, you're like, oh, that's not a very good place, I might retreat. No one would even know. And I'd probably be like, you know what? This is probably a better place. That, whatever. The goal of the EQ is reducing it so you come in underneath. If I've got other videos on that. Smash that in my course. Yeah. Which one's which at the moment. I think that melody is this one. This one looks, it's approaching a drop. This is a bit dangerous, but I'm kind of liking this. So Okay, that's this one. That's my old song. If this one kicks in with a vocal now, I'm in trouble. Yeah, I had a feeling. I got. I held that. The idea. I've got this, like, let's say you're getting bored, you want to add an effect. I'll do echo and a noise. Listen to this, it's kind of cool. Hear that? I'll turn it up. I'll show you. I think I've got a video coming out where I'm going to talk all about beat effects, color effects versus beat effects, but I find driving with effects, they're best used together. So instead of just being like noise, that's what people do. People are just going like this. Right, but I'm saying let's add a little, like I'd never do it now, right? But I can add an echo to that effect. Listen, it's kind of cool. Sound. I'm keeping it kind of low in the mix. Let's do one here. Okay, you're just sort of messing around now. Okay, cool. Okay, let's go one more. What key is that? 8A. Okay, here's one. 9A. Cool. Yeah, I got lucky. See, I don't know what this one's gonna do. I don't know. So. And see, this coming to a drop. I'm gonna get rid of this one. It's just safer. Okay, and what I find is where mixing sometimes goes wrong, it's just sometimes you're just drawing it out and putting too much together. If you feel your new song's kicking into a new bit, maybe it's just a good time to get the other one out, it's a lot safer. But then again, if I knew this song, so my dogs are getting into it, woo! Anyway, right, but if I knew this in advance, like, and didn't know it, I might be like, this might go well with it. Especially if that's not doing much. But that's where preparation comes in. So what do you do personally? Are you someone that likes to prepare their tracks and map their songs in advance with cue points to assure that you'll always play the best parts of each track? Or do you just put your tracks into your software or on a USB and get to know your tracks through jamming them? Now, I'll be honest, right? There is no winner. There's no one way is better than the other. They're just different, right? And I personally feel mixing without cues, it's all about the journey, as mixing with cues is about creating maximum energy on your dance floor. And honestly, like I mentioned, they have both have their time and their place. Now, personally, right, I do like setting cue points. And if you're jamming without cues and you're like, oh, that bit would have been really good there, or perhaps you're finding your transitions are not working as well as you want them to, or maybe they're too drawn out, like you have these big gaps between transitions where there's not a lot happening, then 100%, right? You should give setting cue points a try. Now, anyway, right, thanks again for watching. I hope you found this video super useful and inspiring. And for all the people regularly tuning in and leaving positive comments, you know, like, you have no idea how much it means to me. Like, I really appreciate your support. I actually really love doing this, and to have that like you guys love that, means a lot to me. I honestly feel we're building like a really cool tribe here, and I'm gonna always do my best, right, to keep videos relevant to the issues people face and all the questions you all have. And also, just one thing quickly, if you have requested a video, like I know there's one on trance, for instance, right, and people are wanting that and it's taking me a while to do, please understand, right, like my true baby is my course, and I just spent the last 3 months building a new section which covers like a creative mixing masterclass series, a whole section on three-deck mixing, and also a whole section on advanced effect combinations. So please keep in mind, right, the YouTube stuff is like, it's me freestyling, having some fun, but the course is my blood, sweat, and passion, right? So you should get it. Anyway, right? Thanks again for being part of the Club Ready tribe. And remember, life is nothing more than a reflection of what you focus on. So think big, my friends. Is that feeling that you can do this? It's honestly more than wishful thinking. I know you can, and I'm gonna hold your hand the whole way. Okay, cheers.